everyone, this is Moses, the one who help you if you're interested to study in Korea. And this is Q&A episode 8 for studying in Korea. So let's start with the first question. The first question. Hey Moses, can I apply for architecture engineering as a major in Korean university? Please reply. Guys, you can think of this as original question, right? But starting with a conclusion, yes, you can apply. But there is something you must check before that. So now look at the picture here. Like, this document is from 2020 GKS scholarship. But if you look attentively here, majors that cannot be applied are listed. It says that you can't apply for architecture majors, including medicine, dentistry, and pharmacy, that almost all of you like. But basically, it says that it is 5 years course, is not supported by GKS. But when I looked at the GKS 2021 document, the attention part was not listed. When I searched by one by one, architecture was not supported, but architecture engineering was listed in available majors. So the reason I'm saying this is that you should also check if the major you want to study is listed or available. And down here, this is the document that you have to search, and it can be found if you search the keyword GKS/U on the official website of Study in Korea. So check it out. Question number two. Moses, we have to take the TOPIK exam after flying to Korea, or take the TOPIK exam in our country. If you look here, your score, if it is above TOPIK level 3, you will get 10% bonus in the evaluation. And if it is possible, I would like to tell you to pass the test and get your TOPIK score before applying for the scholarship. And many people try to take the TOPIK test before coming to Korea, but the fact is a lot of students really took the TOPIK test before coming to Korea. And to answer you, you don't need to wait to take the test in Korea. You can take it even in your country. The problem is TOPIK exams are not held in all countries. So if you look here, it is held in total of 86 countries excluding Korea. So to see if it is held in your country, you can go directly to the official TOPIK test website and check if your country is listed. Question number three. Are there any English teacher in Korea? Yes, of course there are many English teachers in Korea, including Koreans and also foreigners. The next one, do we get Korean language training here? And this question says that if you are selected for the GKS scholarship, do you have to study Korean? We will talk about this part while checking the GKS announcement together. Now, look here. It stated that all scholarship students must take a Korean language training for 1 year. In this case, you can be exempt if you have the TOPIK level 5 or higher. And if you don't have a TOPIK level 5, you must spend this 1 year studying Korean language. Because if you want to study at a university in Korea, you have to think of Korean classes. So, of course, there are lecturers in English, but it is impossible to listen all your lecturers in English. Question number four. How easy is to get a job after learning the language if I already have a degree from my home country? Guys, this is really a basic question. If you want to find a job in Korea, your Korean language proficiency have to be fluent. And if you can't speak Korean, of course, it might be possible to get a job, but it is almost impossible. And in fact, there are so many jobs in Korea that are disappearing, which means Korean also are having a hard time to get a job. So how hard will it be for a foreigner who can speak Korean? And even if a foreigner is an expert to the job, if it is a Korean company, the communication in Korean will be essential. So you also asked me, what if you got a degree in your country? In my experience, unless it is a prestigious university in the United States, Japan, China, or European university, it's hard to be greatly accepted. So I think they will prefer Korean university because the job will be done here in Korea. Question number 5. Your video is really helpful. Thank you. I want to know something. Doing master's in international trade, the scope and the job opportunity in Korea, and the best university for that. Please, can you help? Okay. To be honest, it's not easy. Like, it's impossible, almost impossible. Because actually, not only this friend, but a lot of friends asked me this question and asked me like employment related to international trade field. But actually, I called to a staff working in a National Institute of International Education and also asked to various university, but I didn't found any case where foreigner got a job in this field. So in my opinion, there are many Korean fluent in foreign languages, and because of that, there's no opportunity for us foreigners. Yes guys, today was the Q&A episode 8. Was it helpful? Guys, if you have any other question you want to ask, I recommend you first to go and check the Q&A series, because when I look to the comments, I found out almost all the questions are the same. So please check the series, and then if your answer is not there, please leave a comment below and I will come up with the answer. So let me end up the video here and see you in the next one. Bye.